Welcome for today's video lecture of maths. Today we are going to learn a new concept in the fourth chapter, factors and multiple. The concept is divisible numbers. In the previous chapter we have learned the process of division, operation of division, how to do. Okay, for examples we'll take some examples here. 72 divided by 7, 72 divided by 8, 72 divided by 9, 72 divided by 6 will take, okay? 10 will take. Now see, why I have taken same number here that I am going to tell you later. See, when we divide 72 by 7, if you want to divide 72 by 7, what answer you will get and what remainder you will get, see. 7 ones are 7. 7 and 7, 0. Let's bring this to down. Now, 2 is smaller than 7, but we have to divide it. So, we will divide by 0. 7, 0 are 0. So, see here, when we divided 72, when we divided 72 by 7, what quotient we have got? The quotient we have got is 10, and this 2 is what? Remainder. 2 is what? Remainder. That is, remainder is 2. Quotient is same, remainder is 2. Okay, now let's divide 72 by 8. Let's divide 72 by 8 and let's check what remainder and quotient we are getting. So see, 8 ones are 8, 8 to the 16, 24, 32, 40, 48, 56, 64, and 8 nines are 72. 8 nines are 72. 2 minus 2 is 0, 7 minus 7 is 0. So here quotient is 9 and remainder is 0. Okay, let's divide 72 by 9. 9 into 9, 9 to the 18, 9 3 are 27, 36, 45, 54, 63, and 9 8 are 72. 9 8 are 72. See here. When we divided 72 by 9, we got when we come to the table till 12, we say table of 19 8 are 9 8 are 9 8 are 72. So 2 minus 2 is 0, 7 minus 7 is 0. Okay, so here quotient is 8 and remainder is 0. And let's divide 72 by 10. 10 7s are 70. 10 7s are 70. So 2 minus 0, 2, 7 minus 7, 0. Here quotient is 7, but remainder is 2. Now observe these 4 examples which we have taken here. When we divided 72 by 7, we got quotient 10 and remainder we got 2. Remainder we got 2. When we divided 72 by 8, we got remainder 0. When we divided 72 by 9, we got remainder 0. When we divided 72 by 10, we got remainder 2, not 0. Okay, so by observing these 4 examples, what we can conclude or what we can come to the conclusion, see, in the first and last example, in the first and last example, the remainder is other than 0. Remainder is other than 0, it is 2, okay? It's not 0. And in the second and third example, in the second and third example, remainder is 0. Now, with this, we can make two rules or two statements. See here, when a number is divided by any small number and we are getting, if you are getting in the division, if you are getting remainder 0, if you are getting remainder 0, that means here 72 is exactly divisible by 8. Understood? When we divided 72 by 8, we got remainder 0. That means 72 is exactly divisible. Means when 72 is divided into group of 8, perfect groups, perfect group of 8 things are possible. There is no anything is remaining. For example, there are 72 pains. There are 72 pains. Okay. So if you want to make a group of 8 pains of those 70, there exactly how many groups are possible? 9 groups are possible. Now 8 pain is remaining there. That is what 72 is divisible by 8. 72 is divisible by 8. So here 72 is divisible by 8 because remainder is getting 0. Whereas here see when we divided 72 by 7, we got remainder 2. That means what? 72 is not divisible by 7. 72 is not divisible by 7 because we are getting remainder other than 0. Other than 0 means 1, 2, 3. That means we cannot make exactly exact group of 72 when we divide it into 7, 7. Okay? So 72 is not divisible by 7. 72 is not divisible by 7. Similarly, 72 is not divisible by 10 also. Okay, here. So, and 10. And 10. So, 72 is not divisible by 7, and 72 is not divisible by 10, whereas 72 is divisible by 8 and 9. Correct? When we divided 72 by 9 here also in this process of division, we got remainder 0. That means 72 is exactly divisible by 9. Understood? So now, since 72 is divisible by 8 and 9, 72 is divisible by 8 and 9, that means another statement here. 8 and 9, that means 8 and 9 are factors of 72. We have seen the concept of factors. If 72 is divisible by 8 and 9, that means what? That means what? 8 and 9 are factors of 72. 8 and 9 are factors of 72. Understood? Another example we will take so that your concept will be clear. See here, for example, we will take 81, okay, and 81 is divisible by, suppose we divide 81 by 3, then see 3 2s are 6, 8 minus 6 is 2, 3 7s are 21. See, when we divided 81 by 3, we got remainder 0, that means 81 is divisible by 3, 81 is divisible by 3. Since 81 is divisible by 3, so 3 is what? 3 is a factor of 81. Since 81 is divisible by 3, 3 is factor of 81. Whereas, suppose if you take 81 divided by 4, then see 4 2s are 8. 8 minus is 0, let's bring 1 down, 4 zeros are 0, okay? 1 minus 0, 1. See, when we divide 81 by 4, we want remainder 0, that means 81 is not divisible by 4. 81 is not divisible by 4. And since 81 is not divisible by 4, so 4 is not a factor of 81. 4 is not a factor of 81. Understood? So same examples we are going to solve in this practice 4.8. If you are getting remainder 0, then that number is divisible. And if the bigger number is divisible by smaller number, that smaller number is factor of that bigger number. Okay? So see the first example in practice 4.8. Say yes or no for each of the following. See the question. Is 10 a factor of 623? Is 10 a factor of 623? We have to check. We have to check, find out whether 10 is factor of 623 or not. And if it is factor of 623, then we have to write yes, it is factor of 623. Okay? How to check? Just now I have shown you how to check whether 10 is a factor of 623. When 10 can be the factor of 623? When 623 will be exactly divisible by 10. Okay? And when we can say that yes, it is divisible by 10, when in the division we will get remainder 0. So what we have to do here? We have to divide 623 by 10. So let us divide 623 by 10. Okay? So now see, 10, 6 are 60, 2, 0, let's bring 3 down, 10, 2 are 20, correct? So 3 minus 0, 3, 2 minus 2, 0. Now see, in this process of division, we are not getting remainder 0, we have got remainder 3. And what is meaning of this? Is 10 a factor of 623? No. So we have to write here. No. Okay? 10 is not factor of 623. Second, is 7 a factor of 987? Again, we go by same way. First, we will divide 987 by 7, and if you are getting remainder 0, then we can say yes, 7 is factor of 987. 7 ones are 7. 9 minus 7 is 2. Okay? Let's bring it down. 7 fours are 28. So 8 minus 8 0, 2 minus 2 0. Let's bring 7 down. 7 1 is 7. So see, in this process of division, when we divide 87 by 7, what remainder we have got? 0. And that means 7 is factor of 987. Okay, so what will that answer here? Yes. Understood? So remaining two examples in this question, C and D, you have to solve by yourself in this way. Okay, see the second question. Check whether the statement is true or false. Now here statements are given. Same statements are there, same process we are going to do. What is statement? 5 is a factor of 725. In SST or science, you have solved the questions of true or false. There the one statement is given and we have to write whether the statement is true or false. Here also we have to do same, just we have to, first we have to check. We have to check it whether it is true or false. We have to show the explanation. We don't have to write directly, okay? So what will be the explanation? What? 5 is factor of 725. So we have to check whether 5 is factor of 725 or not. So we need to divide 725 by 5. There is another method of checking directly, which is that directly without doing division here you can check. Which is that method? What you use here? Divisibility test. Remember divisibility test, just by seeing last digit. According to the divisibility test of 5, if the last digit is 0 or 5, then the number is divisible by 5. Now here in 725, last digit is 5. That means 725 is divisible by 5. And once it is confirmed that yes, it is divisible by 5, then we can say that 5 is factor of 725. So this statement will be true. But we have to write here, we have to divide here 725 and show whether the remainder is getting 0 or not. Okay? So let's divide 5 ones are 5. 7 minus 5 is 2. Let's bring 2 down. We get 22. 5 fours are 20. Correct? 2 minus 2 is 0. Sorry, 2 minus 0 2 and 2 minus 2 0. Let's bring 5 down. We get 25. 5 5s are 25. Okay? So 5 minus 5 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0. So here in this process of division we are getting remainder 0. That means 725 is exactly divisible by 5. And since 725 is divisible by 5, so 5 is factor of 725. Okay. So 5 is a factor of 725. This is the statement. And have we checked it? Yes. We have proved it. Yes, it is correct. So the statement is true. The statement is true. Okay? Let's do a second one. Same way. So the statement is 7 is a factor of 398. 7 is factor of 398 and we have to check whether this given statement is true or false. Okay? So, let's check by dividing 398 by 7. See here 7, 5 is a 35, correct? 9 minus 5 4, 3 minus 3 0, let's bring it down. 7, 6 is 48, 7, 6 is 42, 7, 7 is 49, so smaller number than 48 is 42 in table of 7. 8 minus 2 is 6, 4 minus 4 is 0. Now here remainder is not 0, it is 6. So according to the rule, if the remainder is not 0, that means 398 is not divisible by 7. And since it is not divisible by 7, 7 is not factor of 398. So the given statement is 7 is no factor of 398. So the statement is false. The statement is false. Understood? So in this way, you have to solve this practice 4.8. In this question also, there are two more examples which you have to solve by yourself. Okay? So thank you for today and have a nice day.